My Uncle Billy had always been so strong and full of life, always on the move, traveling to new places, and succeeding in every hobby he took up. Whether it was winning awards for his photography or scoring 16 jackpots in the Atlantic City casinos, Uncle Billy was determined to be triumphant. But June of last year, my uncle was faced with something he could not defeat, stage 4 pancreatic cancer. As the cancer progressively controlled his life, taking away his strength and energy, it became harder and harder to see what good could come from this. But my Uncle Billy did not lose himself to the cancer. He continued to be the determined teacher and role model my siblings and I had always known.
Hello, my name is Patrick. I'm Jillian's brother. I was also very close to my Uncle Billy. He was a role model to me. Two of the things that I really respected about my uncle was that he always kept growing and he never let anything stop him. And everything that he put his mind to, he always succeeded, because whenever he put his mind to something, he'd complete it and do it better than anyone else.
Lasting impact is probably a sense of responsibility, a sense of duty, a sense of self-sustenance. I think he instilled that not only in me, but in most people that he interacted with. You're always responsible for your own actions. And I think that's probably one of the greatest traits that I hope that rubbed off on me as a young man and later in life as an adult.
While I don't have any pictures to document the time spent with my Uncle Billy, my family and I have kept our best memories fresh in our minds. Every minute we had spent with Uncle Billy that summer was a blessing that taught my siblings and I to treasure everything the world had to offer and be thankful for an uncle as special as our Uncle Billy. When we were younger, my Uncle Billy took each of my siblings and I on our own special day trip. My trip was to the Philadelphia Art Museum. I remember I was so excited because we took the train and I had never taken a train before. On the ride there, my uncle told me all about his life travels, his childhood, and he showed me where his apartment in Philly used to be.
Hey, my name's Luke and I'm Jillian's brother, and I want to talk about how my uncle impacted my life greatly. One way that he impacted my life was like through our fishing trips. On the fishing trips, he taught me skills and on fishing in addition to telling me about many life lessons and adventures. My Uncle Billy left me all of his fishing equipment so that I can continue the activity that we enjoyed to do together. Tell me that you'll
open your eyes. When I think of your Uncle Billy, my brother Billy, I often think fondly of the time when I was about 8 years old and I went on our first fishing trip and I caught a horseshoe crab in the Margate Bay. He had just come back from the service and I was just a little boy and we had a great afternoon, had lunch in his van. He had a work van and we opened the side doors of the work van. It was pouring rain, but he had promised to take me fishing. Even though it was raining, we still went down and made the best of it, fished out of the side of the work van. And it was a great memory and one I often think of when I think of Billy.
One of the biggest impacts my uncle left on me came in the form of a piece of sea glass and an allegory. One night, my uncle brought out a glass jar filled with sea glass. He told me to pick out my favorite piece and offered to make me a necklace. After I picked out a piece, Uncle Billy began to tell me the story behind his collection. He explained to me how every morning before he was no longer physically able, he would walk down to the beach and pick up trash as he watched the sunrise. He then further explained that he did this out of respect for his mother, whose ashes were in the ocean, and all the sea glass was collected on one of these morning walks. The next morning, I woke up before sunrise and walked down to the beach and began to search the beach for trash. By the next Sunday, Uncle Billy had finished making my sea glass necklace, and he gave it to me along with his entire collection of sea glass. I wore his necklace every day for an entire year as I remembered his words, "Wear it for a lifetime in good health." Now, out of respect for my uncle and my grandmother, Every time I am at the beach, I pick up every piece of trash I see as I remember all the grace and happiness they both brought into this world.